a lot of Iranians, they come without their relatives. So really they don't have their mother, their sister, the aunt, everybody around them. So they do not have that support. So these people really, they don't have, most of them, they don't have anybody around them for even the daily thing that after operation or after chemo, 1 or 2 days after chemo, they can't really have, you know, to stand up and cook for themselves. Or talk to each other. So basically for physical activities and spiritual or mental thing, there is nothing to support the other communities that they have language barriers. The other things that is I know, and it's a good thing that they tell the healthcare system that you have to be honest with them, but sometimes I found them very rude and very direct to the patients. Nobody likes to hear that, okay, you are not going to leave more than 6 months. I know that they have to tell the patient or the person who has cancer, but they can say it with, you know, with a little bit of passionate, be passionate about it, nicer, or I don't want to say indirect, but they can wait a few days. But some of them, when I tell them that, okay, don't tell this, you know, director. No, it's our job. We have to say it. In our culture, we don't, a lot of people that they live in Iran and they have cancer, they don't know that they have cancer. They don't tell them. I'm not saying this is good, but because people, they have to know to do something about their wishes and to know that if they're not living long, they have to do something about their life and do whatever they want to do. But that's very extreme of that way, and here is very extreme, that they don't say it with passionate or, you know, in a nicer way, I can say.